Hi, welcome to Watt Hour. In this video we are going to test this dual power supply of 12 volts with input of 13 to 30 volts and output plus and minus 12 volts. The rated current they said is 3 ampere at certain condition, but continuously 2 ampere. I'm going to test it. Let's get started with this. Here I bought it from this store from AliExpress. I will provide you the link for $11.12, but you will get it around in 80 business days. But if you pay higher shipping cost, like $2 or $3 more, you can get it in 60 days or 30 days. I bought it from this store, no affiliation with this. I will provide you the link to buy it. And the module also comes with these standoff. Dual power supply is such that you have ground and then you have 12 volts plus and 12 volts minus with respect to this ground. So from this point, if you put your multimeter, you will get 12 volts, which I'm going to show you. And if you keep the negative here and bring your positive at this point, this shows negative, which means this is actually ground and that's a positive with respect to this point. So if you keep this as a reference, this is negative and that's positive, and many op amp and circuits need this. So we have an input, very simple, two wires here. They've labeled it, this side is positive, this side is negative, and we have a power switch. And as you can see here, the main input capacitor is 35 volts, so you cannot exceed 35, otherwise this will explode. And we have this chip, which is 5430. This is 5430, but it's not. They put here TPS. Maybe it is TPS, but this is not from Texas Instrument. So this model is from Texas Instrument. I'm not sure. I could not find the actual manufacturer of this. But if it is from Texas Instrument, then they used the configuration of the same chip here, one for negative, one for positive. We have just two inductors with capacitors at the output. There is nothing special here. And they put the specs here. This has nothing to do with this module. It says 5 to 28 volts. Incorrect, because if you go 5 volts, so this is just specification of the chip. Nothing to do with this module. This is just misleading information. Input is now 13 volts up to 30 volts, and in all those we will get 12 volts. Now let me show you the chip under the digital magnifier. Now you can see it better. So that is 5430, and also the other chip on this side is also 5430. And then we have this Schottky diode here, SS34, and one more in here, SS34. And the voltage is being programmed with these two resistors. This is 302, this 2 means 2 zeros. So this is 3000 or 3 kilo ohm, and this is 273, this is 27 kilo ohm. This 3 means kilo or 1000. So they've used these two to adjust the voltage. With setting these, we are getting 12 volts. In both cases, we have the same resistors in here, 302 and 273. And here is a data sheet. If this chip is the same chip, this number matches, but the rest, this specification is the input for the chip. But as I mentioned, so this is a configuration with simple components. So here is the adjusting output voltage. So this is a formula that is used with these components. They suggested it should be 1% tolerance resistor to get better voltage. The module is 49.6 millimeters, so perhaps this was 50 by 50. And around 12 millimeter thick. So here the input voltage 25 volts, and if we check the output voltage, I'm putting the negative in here and positive here, 12 volts. So these two terminals are 12 volts positive, and if I put that there, you see negative 12 volts. Now let's test it with the load. I'm going to connect the output of this to my electronic load where I can set different currents. Here is my electronic load. This is the electronic load DL3031, and these are the two terminals that from the circuit will be connected in here, and we will see the voltage here and the current. Input is connected here and output is connected via this wire to my electronic load, and here is the screen for my electronic load. See, I've connected it to this terminal first, then I'm going to connect it to the other one. And here now I've connected, input is now 30 volts, output is 12 volts, and we are reading also the current. Let's go with 1 ampere. And here with 30 volts input, 458 milliampere input, output is 1 ampere, 12.3 volts, and here is the efficiency. Let's go with 2 ampere. Now with 2 ampere, 900 milliampere is the input, output is 12.2 volts, 12.3, 2 ampere. Now this chip is getting hot. And here I've connected my thermal camera. The link for the camera is below the video. So let's have a look at this. So that's the hot spot, 80 degrees Celsius now. If I put my finger, you will see that's the chip. This is the chip. And here, if I put my finger, you'll see that's the chip. 79 degrees Celsius. Let's reduce the voltage to 24 volts. As you can see, input current is increasing. So input is now 24 volts, 24, output is 12.3, very steady, about 2 ampere, input current is 1.17 milliampere, here is the efficiency. Let me change this to 1 ampere. And here with 24 volts with 1 ampere output, we are getting 565 milliampere at the input. And here is the efficiency. Now I'm changing this to 15 volts, 18 volts, let's go 18. So input is 18 volts, output 1 ampere. 730 milliampere the input current, and here's the efficiency. Now let me change the current to 2 ampere, and here as you can see at 18 volts we are getting 18 volts we are getting 1465 milliampere input. It's hot, but okay. And here is the efficiency. So the input must be 13 volts, so let's go 13. As you can see, the current is increasing. So now input is 13 volts, output 2 ampere. So you see, we do not get 12 volts. The voltage has dropped. So let's reduce the current to 1 amp, and still we are not getting 12 volts. So 13 volts input, we are not getting 12 volts. Let me increase this voltage and pay attention here. So at 14 volts you can get 12 volts. So minimum is 14 volts if you want 1 ampere. Of course, if I reduce it, it will work, but we are going with the maximum, so if it works with the maximum, the rest will be fine. So 14 volts, 1 ampere works, and 920 milliampere is the input current. Here is the efficiency. Now I'm increasing the current to 2 ampere to see if it works. The voltage dropped, so with 2 ampere, 14 volts doesn't work. Let's increase this. So 14.5 will give you 12 volts with 2 ampere. 1.8 ampere is input current, and here is the efficiency. Let's have a look at the thermal image. 60 degrees Celsius, the chip, because we are using only this positive. So let's go with 3 amp in case to see if it works. Now output is 3 ampere, input current is 2.68. They say that this should be have some kind of heat sink. And here, as you can see, the temperature has increased, 81 degrees, 82 degrees. Very hot. So I will turn it off for now. If you put some heatsink, it will work, but let's not go for that. Now I've connected it between the ground and negative. As you can see, my terminals, the positive is now at the ground and the negative is at the negative. So this point is negative with respect to this point, so that's why I can use the same load. Now let's test it with 1 ampere. So here again, this is minus 12 volts. Keep in mind, this is minus 12 volts with 1 ampere. Input current is 1 ampere again. Voltage is 14 volts, 14.6. 1 ampere is 1.05 ampere is the input current. Output is minus 12 volts, 1 ampere. Here is the efficiency. And here is the efficiency. Now let's go with 2 ampere. That's It didn't work, as you can see, overloaded, it's turning on and off. Temperature control turned it, so the negative is not working. Let's see the thermal image. 108 degrees Celsius. Very hot. The thermal shutdown is now controlling it. So 2 ampere doesn't work, 1 ampere works with minus 12 volts. So now let's go 1.1. I'm increasing it slowly here. 1.1 output, minus 12 volts. Now 1.2, 1.3, doesn't work. So 1.2 still blinks, it heats up. 1.1, so 1 ampere, let's leave it for a few minutes. And here is the thermal image again, 100 degrees Celsius, very hot. Very hot, so 1 ampere is not advised with this minus 12 volts. Let's reduce it. To 800 milliampere, as you can see. Let's see if the temperature drops. Yes, the temperature's already dropped. 87 degrees, 86 degrees, 85 degrees. Yes, so the temperature is dropping. So minus 12 volts, you can get 800 milliampere. And here's the efficiency, but 819 milliampere at the input. Now input is 30 volts, output is 800 milliampere, input current is 400 milliampere at minus 12 volts. Here is the efficiency. Let's see the thermal image, how hot it is. 81 degrees Celsius. So 81, 82, if that increases, it means it's heating up. No, so that's good, 81, 82. Let's go with 24 volts. And here input is 24 volts. Output is minus 12.3. 800 milliampere is the output, input current is 500 milliampere. Here is the efficiency. So 800 milliampere is being drawn here. Let's have a look at the back. So the back of the module is 53 degrees Celsius. With this module, you can get positive and negative 12 volts at 800 milliampere continuously. But if you want to get just use the positive side, in that case, you can get up to 2000 milliampere. And the temperature was around 80 degrees Celsius. So definitely, this is worthy of using if you need positive and negative 800 milliampere. And I've also presented the efficiency. The decision is yours. So this is thumb up the video, please, and also click the subscribe button on this corner. I really appreciate it. In this video, we are going to do the review of this 50 volts, 20 ampere Wuji WZ5020L back converter. 20 ampere or 1 kilowatt. We are going to test it with different voltages, up to 55 volts at the input and up to 20 ampere. Needs more current, so the constant current is